Now here let's start the assembly of mini clamp jaw, bench wise assembly. Now change large icon so it seems more visible. First part we will choose base open. Now just click here, view origin, close, and move your cursor near to origin. See it fixed. Click and fixed. Now hide. Now the next component, fixed jaw. Here choose mat. Just drag. I'll select this one, this circle and the hole. It's going to make concentric relation, that's fine. In the same opposite direction also this one, and inside concentric, okay. Now it is moving. So I'll select this bed and this face, coincide relation, okay. Now body, base and fixed jaw here, insert component. Let's try nut wise, mat, select this hole and this one, keep this one outside concentric relation, okay. This face and this face. Coincident. Now here we need to fix, see it is moving, so we need to fix this one. Now we need to fix this one, so we will apply check right plane, front plane of this fixed jaw nut wise. Hold control key, right plane, see both left and right plane, click mat, it's coincide, okay. Now this is fixed along with this, control key, select both, mat, select this hole and this hole, concentric relation. Even though it's select this face, coincident. Now both inside faces coincide. Select this cylinder and this hole, concentric relation. And let's make parallel, select this face and this face, make sure it is parallel, okay. Now let's cancel and let's rotate. Now let's create limit. Advanced limit. Now I'll select this face. Here minimum 0 and maximum length we will apply 47. See it's 0. and let's move 47. Still there is a gap or there is a chance. Evaluate, measure, select this edge, 7 millimeter more you can add. So go to edit and here plus 7. So it should be 50, okay, 53, let's not that much. See, oh, that's perfect, 53. Insert mat. Jaw screw, control key, handlebar, open. Handlebar, jaw screw. Mat, choose this hole and this one. Keep here reverse. Okay. I'll choose this face and this face. Okay. Concentric relation. Now select hole and bar, concentric relation, okay. Now here we need to create one important relation. Go to advanced mat, choose your width. First let's choose two faces. I'll select one, two. And here tap selection, I'll select this face. See, it's going to fix in mid of the jack screw, okay. Cancel. Now see, now we will apply screw mat also here. Let us finish some more thing. Mat, clear. I'll select this one and this one. Concentric relation, okay. Now here we will apply advanced mat. We will select two faces, one, two, and here also we will apply these two faces. See, it's going to fix in center of this, okay. Now this is movable, so let's keep as it is. Clamp screw. Rotate mat. Now we need to fix select hole, concentric relation. It is not going to there. Now click control, drag, okay, mat. I'll choose this face and this one, concentric relation. Advanced mat, width mat, let me choose these two faces and this one. See, it fixed in center of the screw, clamp screw. Let's apply some mechanical mat screw. Let's say this edge or this one. Distance 1 revolution. Reverse. If you right click, fix. Now you can rotate. See, it's moving down. It's moving up. So this is how we applied. Front plane, sketch, okay. Now here also we want to apply screw thread, mechanical mat, screw. Now here I'll choose this body and I'll select this bench wise inside circle. Keep distance 1 revolution, okay, cancel. Now let's apply. See how screw moving. If I'll rotate, see how bench voice opening. If you rotate this screw, let's go to design library, matrix, nuts, hexagon. There is one nut. Let's bring this nut first to bring this. M10, double chamfers, okay, schematic, if you want reveal thread, okay. Now if you want to add, just click this one and this face, okay. Now it is fixed here. And this is also fixed here. See, if I'll hide this or transparent, see, if you rotate, your sliding jaw will going to fix there. So this is the simple tutorial how to create a fix clamp mini bench vise in SolidWorks. I hope you like. Don't forget to share, like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Thanks for watching.